26 different tips, tricks, and features. Today, we're covering the A to Z of Affinity Photo. All resources featured here today can be found on Envato Elements, where you get unlimited downloads of graphics, photos, and fonts, millions of creative digital assets with simple commercial licensing. I'm Abby Esparza with Envato Tuts Plus, and we have a whole alphabet to cover, so let's jump right into it. A is for the Assets panel. The Assets panel is an area for storing any commonly used images or textures. From cutouts to watermarks, anything you find yourself using over and over can be drag dropped and stored here. You can create different categories to organize your assets, and once an item is placed, it'll stay even if you delete the file from its original location. The Assets panel is hidden by default, but you can turn it on by going to View, Studio, Assets. B is for the Blemish Removal Tool. Affinity Photo has multiple different tools for removing those pesky zits, and the Blemish Removal Tool is one of the easiest. Click the Blemish Removal Tool from the Tools panel. Adjust the context toolbar settings to what best suits your needs, and then click on the target area to instantly remove any blemishes. This tool is considered destructive as it does permanently edit the pixels of a layer. However, it's great for any quick, on-the-fly retouches. C is for channels. Channels in Affinity Photo can do a whole slew of different things. However, my favorite way to use them is to create complicated selections. Select the Channels panel. Choose the channel that best represents the areas you'd like to select, keeping in mind that the white areas will be what's selected. And then hold Control and click that channel. A selection will be created. Now, you can use this selection to pinpoint things like adjustment layers. Here, I use channels to create a layer mask, pinpointing any of the highlights of the image. So I could then increase those highlights using a mask, brightness, contrast, adjustment layer. D is for dodge and burn. You can use the dodge and burn brushes to do everything from remove wrinkles and acne to adding contrast or enhancing shadows. Instead of using the default dodge and burn tools, however, try this less destructive way. Create two curves layer, invert both of their layer masks by hitting Ctrl-I, which will fill those layer masks with black. Next, bring up and brighten the image using one of the curves layer, while lowering and darkening the image in the other. Now, using a soft round brush set to a low flow and the color white, paint on the curves layer masks using the brighter curves layer to dodge and the darker curves layer to burn. E is for the elliptical depth of field. A great finishing touch to add to any image, whether it be a simple retouch or a full-on image composite, is to add some depth of field. Select the layer you'd like to add some depth to. Select Live Filters found on the bottom of the Layers panel, and then choose Depth of Field. From here, you can set the mode to elliptical and adjust the blur's starting and ending points. The radius setting determines just how much blur will be added, while the vibrance and clarity will affect the whole image, not just the blurred portions. F is for Frequency Separation. Frequency separation is a well-known trick to get that perfectly retouched skin. It splits your photo into a high-frequency layer containing texture and a low-frequency layer containing color. Other photo editing software requires you to create or download a third-party action to run and then create the frequency separation layers. But Affinity Photo has it built right in. You can find it under Filters, Frequency Separation. From here, you can use the clone brush tool on both of those layers, fixing colors and details separately. G is for gradient. The gradient tool is a classic and must-have for any photo editing software, but Affinity Photo does it one step better by having the gradient result show live as you place it. As someone who has placed the same gradient over and over in Photoshop trying to get that perfect angle and spread, the Affinity Photo Live Gradient feature is a treat. H is for history. When saving a file in Affinity Photo, you can choose to save your history states as well by choosing Save History File with Document. This lets you pick up exactly where you left off, undos and all. I is for Image Brush. Affinity Photo has two different types of brushes. An intensity brush captures the shape and opacity of an image and will stamp a solid color, just like you might see in Photoshop. An image brush, however, is a brush that contains the shape, opacity, and color values of an image, turning the whole image, color details included, into its very own brush. J is for duplicate. Duplicate your whole layer by hitting Ctrl J. Duplicating a layer multiple times is a great way to intensify an effect in a hurry. This works especially well on glow or backlighting layers. Think overlay, screen, and soft light. K stands for CMYK. CMYK stands for cyan, magenta, yellow, and black. But did you know that K doesn't actually stand for black, but instead stands for key color? When a photo editing software like Affinity Photo uses the CMYK color space, the key color is just always black, which makes way more sense. L is for LUTs. LUT files are used all over the film and video editing world, but that doesn't mean photo editors can't use them. Affinity Photo lets you download custom LUT files that'll give your images an instant color grade. Just go to Layer, New Adjustment Layer, 3D LUT Adjustment, choose the LUT you'd like to load, and the effect will be applied to all the layers below the created LUT Adjustment Layer. M is for macros. Macros run multiple operations all in a row, turning several clicks into just one. Have a sequence of settings you run on every image, press play to record it, and then save it as a macro to supercharge your workflow. Go to View Studio Macro to activate the Macros panel. N is for noise reduction. Noise reduction in Affinity Photo is as easy as going into the develop persona, choosing details, and then adjusting the different luminance settings. Drag the luminance to increase the noise reduction, decreasing the noise without compromising the details of your image. O is for crop tool overlays. With the crop tool active, hit O to cycle through different crop tool overlays, including the golden spiral. When the golden spiral overlay is active, you can press Shift O to change its orientation, flipping it left, right, up, and down. P is for personas. Personas change Affinity Photo to suit a specific step or role in editing. Doing some image compositing, there is the photo persona. Time for some raw adjustments. Jump into the developer persona, and now your workspace has all the panels you need and none of the ones you don't. There is also the Liquify persona, export persona, and more. Q is for quick create brushes. Create an image brush instantly by selecting a layer with an extracted object that you'd like to make a brush from. Now in the brush panel, go to menu and select new brush from selection. Instant image brush. R is for refine selection. Have a particularly hairy subject you are dreading to extract? Just grab a quick selection of a subject using the selection brush tool. Then in the upper context bar, choose refine. Now drag the refine selection brush over the edges of the subject's hair. Refine edge will do all of the heavy lifting. Set output to mask and then click apply. S is for snapshots. Snapshots store a version of your current work, kind of like a freeze frame. This allows you to create multiple versions of your work that you can then flip back to if you end up not liking the direction you went, and have long since run out of undo states. To create a snapshot, make sure the Snapshots panel is open, and then from that panel, click Add Snapshot. The snapshots save with your document and never reset. T is for the text tool. Hitting T will activate the text tool, which Affinity Photo has built in spell checking for. Type your text and a classic red line will make sure you don't miss any of those pesky errors. right-click the spelling mistake, and Affinity Photo will give you a list of possible options. If the word isn't misspelled, just choose Learn Spelling, and it will be added to Affinity Photo's dictionary. U is for User Interface. Affinity Photo's interface is completely customizable, everything from dragging and rearranging tools to choosing either a dark or light UI. Go to Edit, Preferences, User Interface to change any of your UI settings. V is for the View tool. Need to quickly pan to another portion of your document? Don't bother switching tools. Just hold down space to temporarily switch to the View tool. Click and drag where you need to go, and then let go of space. Your tool will switch to whatever tool you were using last. W is for watercolor. Affinity Photo comes with a pack of ultra-realistic watercolor brushes, pre-installed. Choose from dense brushes, dry or diluted brushes, or even brushes for a light wash of color to a dry, fine fiber brush. You can find these brushes in the Brushes panel under Watercolors. X is for swap colors. Doing some masking and need to switch between black and white over and over? Hitting X will instantly swap between your foreground and background color. Hands down, one of my most used shortcuts. Y is for Liquify. Doing a retouch and need to do some liquifying? Affinity Photo has a persona just for it. Switch from the default photo persona to the Liquify persona using the upper persona bar. Here is where you'll find all of your liquifying tools, so you can push and pull to your heart's content. Switching back to the photo persona once finished. Z is for undo. Control Z, otherwise known as undo. And when it comes to undoing, Affinity Photo doesn't mess around, giving you over 8,000 undo states. Go to Edit, Preference, Performance, Undo Limit to choose just how many undo states you want. Keep in mind, you can always lower the amount of undos for a possible increase in performance. And there you have it, 26 letters, 26 different Affinity Photo features. But if that wasn't enough and you're looking to learn even more, why not check out some of the other excellent videos that Envato Tuts Plus has to offer. If you like this video and would like to see more, consider giving us a like and even subscribing if you haven't already. And don't forget to click the little bell icon to be notified of all new videos, including tips, tricks, and tutorials. Happy designing, see you next time.